I use PaperJS because it's like a really nice library to create vector graphics. And I started my generative stuff with processing and P5. And that's an amazing, amazing library, amazing framework. But at the time where I did this, it sort of lacked proper export for vector graphics. And I also was missing certain functions. Like if you maybe have worked with Inkscape, you have usually functions that can do Boolean operations, maybe like can merge shapes or cut out shapes and stuff. Mm. And this is super helpful if you do anything CNC pen plotter related. And that's why I go with PaperJS.
I've pulled up your frozen system, Snowflake PCBs. And this is so cool because not only can people order these from PCBWay, but also you can generate your own because you shared all of this stuff on GitHub. I started watching your video on how you procedurally generate PCBs. So what's your workflow for this?
So I use KiCad. And at first I thought like, I can just maybe import SVGs directly. I'm rather new to PCB design, but I very quickly figured out that importing SVGs is rather hard, at least about 1 year ago. Then I was searching around what's the better way to import. And then I stumbled upon Inkscape plugin, which is called SVG to Shenzhen, really nice name. And that does a lot of stuff for you. So you can decide which vector graphic shape goes on which layer on the PCB, and then you can export it as footprint or as whole PCB KiCad project.
That's so cool.
Amazing. Yeah, that's such a great tool. So it's a plugin for Inkscape, and it has one function which sets up your project to fit the workflow. So it creates a bunch of layers for you, which resembles the copper layer or the solder mask layer and stuff. And then you can open your already created SVG file or make a new one, whatever. And then you like sort it onto the layers where you want it to go in KiCad. And then it's just export, opening KiCad, done.